5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
E adesso una storia che comincia a Roma e finisce molto lontano, la storia di un designer che si è posto il problema di come portare i più giovani nel mondo della tecnologia, Valentina, Chinnici.
Possible, although it seemed very impossible, to make education inclusive, find a conjunction between humanities and technologies. So I studied educational sciences in Rome, at the Università Roma Tre, and thanks to the Erasmus program, I was able to study and I won an internship at London Metropolitan University. So my main goal was to use mobile technologies to enhance learning. So these are a few pictures that we took at the induction training that we did at Ravensbourne University in London. And I'm a very anxious person, so the moment I was informed that I was going to London, it was my first time abroad, I was scared. But in the end, London was a eye-opening experience, and it blew my mind. After my 4 months in London, I came back to Rome, and I attended the first makeup fair in Rome, and literally, it blew my mind. I wanted so bad to be part of this new movement that I wrote my thesis about makers and the way they could revolutionize formal education. And today there was my professor from Roma Tre was in here in the audience. So after my graduation, I moved back to London, and this is Ravensbourne University, which is close to the Oxford Arena. And 1 year later, I wasn't just an attendee, I was running a workshop with kids, and this is me running the workshop about an interactive t-shirt that was using little bits and were conductive. But I brought my experience across the globe, literally. So that's me at FabTech Barcelona, then at Maker for Paris, then it's at the bottom of the page, you can see Somerset House and Maker Faire Bay Area. But after my experience with kids, I was also part of a startup called Makerini. I joined the Arduino family, and this is us at Maker Faire Rome last year. Basically, my mission was still there. I wanted to find a way of bringing technologies to a new segment in the market, which was the middle school, which wasn't particularly covered by educational kids. So after a while, I went to bed, which is one of the most important fairs for education in London, and I met with Google. And we discussed about the option of using mobile devices to bring technology in the hands of younger kids. So Google was launching this product called Science Journal, which is like a digital notebook for running experiments. So Arduino could bring to the mobile experience also a hands-on experience. So we ended up creating a kit. And so the Arduino Science Kit was born. But I will let the kids explain what the kit is about.
So many things that you can do with it, and it's all put into one.
I love how you put science and fun together.
There's loads of experiments you can do.
So kind of work it out.
Yes, you can discover it. That's what I'm doing now.
I see this as a far more gender inclusive product. It's certainly not just for boys. I really, really like to push that notion that everybody's equal in my room. This kit makes it much more accessible for people to do practical physics. This could lead us into a new generation of new engineers, new inventors, and maybe, you know, diversify the field.
So with this kit, I think that I accomplished my mission, so bringing this connection between much because this is the new generation of Arduino products that doesn't require any coding. So to wrap it up, I would like to give you this quote by Malcolm X. Education is the passport to the future for tomorrow. Belongs to those who prepare it for today. Thank you very much to everybody.
Grazie mille. Tra l'altro il tema della tecnologia per l'educazione è una delle altre novità di quest'anno di Faire, un'area che è stata proprio curata dai nostri amici di scienza, che è stato parlato di volte un po' di Gasmes, e vi invito a visitarla perché è una novità molto interessante, è un trend molto in crescita di cui è importante parlare.